And there's so many different ways, and not being a fantastic student of God's word, I can only do what I can do. Isaiah chapter 6, let me read the first five verses. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord sitting upon a throne. This was Isaiah speaking. Sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. Above it stood the seraphim. Each one had six wings. Yes. With twain he covered his face, and with twain he covered his feet, and with twain he did fly. And one cried unto another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. And the post of the door moved at the voice of him that cried, and the house was filled with smoke. What was it filled with?
Smoke.
The house was filled with smoke. Then said I, woe is me, for I am undone, because I'm a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For mine eyes have seen something. Mine eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. One more verse here. Then flew one of the seraphims unto me, having a live coal in his hand, which he had taken with the tongs from off the altar, laid it on his mouth, and we can read the rest. Father, bless us now. Send a word from home. Send an anointing, oh God, that is able to destroy yokes and remove burdens. Speak now in Jesus' name. Taking you back to the last clause of verse 4, and the house was filled with smoke. And so I'd like to speak to you this morning, this afternoon. I am covered in smoke. Okay, we know where we're going in a bit. But if we can just say to ourselves, I am covered in smoke. Come on, say that with me. I'm covered. I'm covered in smoke. I'm not talking. I'm not talking that kind of smoke. I'm not talking about tobacco. I'm talking about smoke. The one that takes you into the presence of Almighty God. Smoke is an overflow of the fire. The dictionary said it's a visible vapor in the air that is produced by a burning substance. When something has caught fire, the effects that it gives off is smoke. A few weeks ago, some of us might have seen that 100-some-odd people went into a hold to make a decision about who gonna be the next pope. And the way that you will know that a decision has been made, first thing you're supposed to see is white smoke. And because they had confusions in the past about the color of the smoke, it was going to be followed by bells. Bells ringing. Amen. But this smoke that I'm talking about today, there will be no confusion. It's God's smoke. It will show that there was fire. The fire of God is somewhere burning. And the smoke is the effect that you will see of the fire. Hallelujah. That is burning. In the year that King Uzziah died, Isaiah, who was privileged to be a prophet who spoke in the reign of four kings, he was very close to the king Uzziah. I don't really want to go into that because there's a whole chapter about Uzziah. We know who he was. He was a king that the Bible said did right in the sight of God. God used him to do mighty, mighty things. And under his reign, Judah prospered. God said he made, the word of God said that Uzziah was made to prosper until he got pride in his heart. He assumed to perform a duty that was not given to him. And he went into the temple to burn incense. And when the priest told him, "You can't come in here, we'll do it for you," he got angry. Right in the midst of his anger, God dealt with him. I can just see the smoke of the altar of sacrifice in the foyer. I could just see the smoke at the altar of incense as the incense was being put on the fire and the smoke was going up as a sweet-smelling savor. And Uzziah wanted to be a part of all of this. God said, "No, can't come into my presence." And whilst he was angry, leprosy took him. This was a man that was exalted to be king at 16 years old. Reigned for 52 years old, but the last part of his reign was spent in a leper's house. Couldn't come into the presence of God. But it was in the year that he died, Isaiah marked the occasion. Isaiah was one that was privileged because he was a royal prophet. He could be called to the table to give wise words. And what's God saying today, prophets? He could come into the midst of dignitaries. But what it did to me, this text, it showed me that we can come in the midst of God's house, stand in a pulpit, preach God's word because we know how to coin a phrase, make you jump and shout and say, my wasn't that good. But the preacher hadn't had an experience with Almighty God. Oh yes, and it happens, it happens. Don't think it cannot happen. It happens. All over the land today, near and far, there are preachers everywhere preaching what they know about Jesus, but don't know the man Jesus. I would rather say a few words up in here and know Jesus. They speak with the tongue of men and angels and know nothing about my Lord. In the year King Uzziah died, he saw something. There was no debate about whether he was in a trance, whether he was in his mind, whether he was figuring out. He saw. And as we go down into the text, you will see that Isaiah was privileged to see something that even the seraphims could not look upon.
Yes,
mighty God.
Lord.
He saw the Lord. He said he saw the Lord. Also, it was in the year that King Uzziah died. I don't know what day, but during the year of his death, Isaiah, disheartened and looking for some direction, because sometimes we have to reach to a very low point in our lives when no one else can help us, when nobody else hears us, We have to find God for ourselves.
Amen. In the midnight.
This was the death of one king. A close king. The king died. But Isaiah saw another king. So when one king died, that chapter was closed. Another earthly king sure was coming, but he saw a heavenly king. This one was sitting upon a throne. This one's throne was different. Because it was high. Higher than all the other earthly thrones. And it was lifted up on top of that. Isaiah saw the Lord. He saw a throne, a place of rulership. And sitting on that throne was the rightful king. A king who has authority over his kingdom. And his train, the bottom hem of his garments, the veil, the bottom, the long bit, filled the temple. The temple, which was the dwelling place of God. So he saw a throne high and lifted up. He saw a train that was filling the temple. Three things I want us to notice in this text here. Number one, Isaiah saw the king sitting on a throne high and lifted up. And he was careful to mark out for us that above the throne, so if this throne was already high and lifted up, there's nothing there.